In this video, we'll be checking whether a given value is an eigenvalue for a matrix, and also given a vector, checking if that vector is an eigenvector for that matrix. So let's first just go over the definition of eigenvector and eigenvalue. An eigenvector of an n by n matrix A is a non-zero vector V that has the property that A times V equals lambda V for some scalar lambda, right? So this means that V is a vector such that A times V is just a scalar multiple of V. So there's a few things to note here. One, A is going to be a square matrix. Eigenvectors are only defined for square matrices. Two, eigenvectors, by definition, must be non-zero vectors. And three, this is an existence question. A vector, a non-zero vector, is called an eigenvector if there exists some scalar lambda, so that A times V is that scalar times V. Now, an eigenvalue, a scalar lambda, is called an eigenvalue of an n by n matrix A if there's a non-trivial solution to the equation Ax equals lambda x, i.e., A minus lambda times the identity times x equals 0 has a non-trivial solution. And again, some things to notice. This is only defined for square matrices, and it's just asking about the existence of non-trivial solutions to some equation. So let's use this to check in some examples. So what if I ask you, is lambda equals 2 an eigenvalue of the matrix A equals 3, 2, 3, minus 8? Now this is just asking if A minus 2 times the identity has a non-trivial null space. So A minus 2 times the identity, I can just compute that, and I get this 1, 2, 3, 6 matrix. Now we just have to set up the augmented matrix and row reduce to find the null space. There's my pivot, which tells me the equation A minus 2i equals x equals 0 has a one-dimensional solution set, right? So it has a non-trivial null space for that matrix, A minus 2i, which tells me that lambda equals 2 is an eigenvalue for A. What if we turn it around and ask the other way? Suppose I give you a vector 3 minus 2, 1, and ask you, is this an eigenvector of the following matrix? And if so, find the corresponding eigenvalue. So we just need to compute A times V, and that's the matrix vector product. We just compute it and get minus 15, 10, minus 5, which we notice is minus 5 times the vector 3, minus 2, 1 that we were given. Right, so it's 5 times the vector itself, which means V is an eigenvector of A with eigenvalue 5. Now, a few remarks before we finish up here. One, eigenvectors, by definition, cannot be the zero vector. That said, eigenvalues are allowed to be zero. So any vector V that's in the null space of a square matrix, if V is not zero, then V is going to be an eigenvector of A with eigenvalue equal to zero. And finally, eigenvectors, we'll see, these are nice in the sense that they tell us which directions in which multiplication by the matrix, which could do some pretty confusing things, right, complicated things, multiplication by A is actually going to act like multiplication by a scalar, right? And so these eigendirections, these eigenvectors, are going to tell us which directions in which multiplication by A is really easier to study. So one of the things that we've seen here is that if we're given an actual scalar lambda, it's easy to check if lambda is an eigenvalue of A. And also, if we're given an actual vector V, it's easy to check if V is an eigenvector for A. Now, if you're not given either one, and you're just asked to find all the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of a given matrix, you have to do more work. And so this is the study of the characteristic equation. I'll make another video for that and link it here.